Welcome back from that short break. Now, of course, we're getting into Kachai right about now, and we shall be having a conversation that has been trending as far as the different students who have failed to sit for their examinations is concerned. That is, of course, the senior four examinations that did start yesterday. Apparently, some students were stopped over failure to complete the fees. And, of course, a couple of figures that are coming in is that most of these students have not completed just 50,000 Ugandan shillings on their fees structure. Now, I want to find out, does actually not completing your school fees mean that you shouldn't sit for the national examinations? Our team was on ground. Of course, there was a school that was affected in Iganga, and we wanted to find out, of course, how it all went down. The RDC was available to talk to us, the couple of teachers and a couple of parents. Let's get to find out what they had to say regarding this particular story before we dive into it.
Funny enough, Basa is above him. Is this a school? We have tried to intervene. Banobana kana banoba scout. Bazirabuzibu. Obuzibu in isomerolin. Is it worth having a center here anymore? Is it worth top care Niweba Kings having a center? To make it worse, Kings ya mayor. Bala. Omwana yena tabuzibwa. Why haven't they stood in with the parents? Abanaku, ababona sente muntu yabakazi, ababona abana ku street. Now the future of these people has been ruined because of the poor administration of this school.
They have been stopped. One, they have minimized the administration. Because we would not involve the police if they had their parents. We warned them and told them, please, even during briefing time, please, if you don't have money to pay, please come with your parent. And we write a commitment and also write a payment plan. Because these teachers will stand before you.
Wakubanga wewa ini balance zi. Tugeziza kukolechi sobo kano kogera. Basa gobi abana na wakuba nemigo. Alumu ike kuisomero. Abana saa weno. Akume ebigezo alobi okuga abana ebigezo nti kubanga gabisege dakika 15 amateka jegalagira tugeziza ku buli kisoboka kidemye no
chintu chimenya ino omutima abantu banga bayiganga likubakobera nti nange chimenya omutima twenza kubanga tona sasula fees msaji na adamu na karakate migo chinchiba chinu chinchiba chidunji bilis abantu bewa mwelwachi
bademya. But if you honestly ask me,
it's very sad.
You have to understand that the school is also a business. But then the school also has to understand. Omuzadde watukira na agamba omwana wange kagende buli lunaku nga talina na za fees. Kimanyi oyo omuzadde ayagala omwana asome naye talina. Tazirina. And I believe there were ways that the school could have handled it. Abana nebakole ebibuzo nebafuna engeri gye babasasula back that money. There are ways. Naye kati omwana agenda kuddamu akole omwaka mulamba. Which means that is extra money on a parent who already couldn't pay for just this one term. It's sad, and it's the same thing as we were talking about with a friend yesterday. So meroligo bo omwana fees aina balance. Chitegera. Na ye
oyo mwana no siminje na etano
nebo ziba nyinji right ezo sente bwo mugoba omubanja na tuleka wiki bwoleta receipt zo mubanja zisigala zezimu kati eyo wiki ja tudde na yaji sasulide echidala ogobi omwana bayino kola ebibuzo lero right kali baze ye ka tebakoze bibuzo bwe banako mawo next term. Togenda basa suzeze mabega. Kubaka tibu ya teba koze bibuzo bia third term. Teba so wala gena musomerochi. Edala. Which means, oyo mzate taina option indala, but to come back. Ako ademu musomeroli ya abademu. Ama somero, I get it. It's a business. It is a business. We do not, as parents, we don't put that down. But at times I think we need to look at a bigger picture. School is not something like akaduka keweba kewewola ko. It's a school. Omuzadde bwajana kugamba mumanyi Chitufu chidi ntichiganya, but this is the payment plan I can work with. Put them into consideration. Abana muba goba neba vayo kusomero, neba tasomezo wikizo, na atane mukomya wa receipt. Nga mwagala full amount, kati nzo mzante, munadiza mutio mwana wange, wiki ebidize mwamu gobera. Tuchebuze. Yo mzade bagenda mudiza oba tia fizi zeno term za sasulido mwano. Bana zimudiza, then yato pinge ape zokola third term.
It's very unfortunate what did happen, and the most unfortunate bit of this story is that it is irreversible. That means, you know, these children have to now go back and, you know, have to find a way of getting back into school. That is for the next year. But Willis, what would you make of, you know, out of what these people decided, the school in particular to begin with?
There's, I think someone, one of the people who talked there is a bursar. And he said that they made a call out to these guys to bring their parents and sign.
And sign, yes.
And he's indicating that they did not. And I think there's a problem there. That, you know, the relationship between the parents, the children, and the school is not...
together.
You know, it's not fluid enough. So the school is on its own. The students are on their own. The parents are also on their own. I don't know if there are some students there who had money and did not pay it. And, you know, probably use it for other things. I don't know if the some parents of those kids were negligent, and I don't know some parents of them who are, you know, because that statement from the bursar makes, it completely changes the story.
True.
And, you know, we have to stop demonizing the school per se, but also listen to both sides.
True.
The other thing I'd like to say is that some of the schools we have in Uganda are run by clumsy people. You know, people think that a bursar and everyone else has to have something to do with education. No, we need people to sit and think, to have counselors, to have people who are, you know, thinking for the school. For example, this was a small number of students, and the school could have made an effort to initiate a conversation with the parents directly, to be able to go to where these kids are coming from and say, Onomwana Derek, Vawano. This, I'm looking at this family, and this is what they can handle. You understand? By the time you register students to sit for final exams, you know their pocket, you know their state of mind, you know everything about them. So this school owes it to society to know what kind of the quality of students they are handing over to UNEB.
Okay.
So if you have registered students, and those 21 are included, UNEB is bringing those 21 papers to you at the school. Yes, so where do they go? This school has to account for that. And I think UNEB also has to sit down and say, if a student has not paid school fees, but they have registered with us, they have our property.
Exactly.
You as a school has to devise means of how to get your money back.
But as a nation,
we
are supposed to make sure every student that
as long as they are registered
they must sit.
Okay.
Unless they die or anything happens. But they should not be prohibited by the school. They should be prohibited. They are now playing by the rules of UNEB.
Not by the rules
of the school. I remember in our briefing, our teachers used to say, we have handed you over
to UNEB.
So you're playing by UNEB rules. I think that's the distinction that we need to make. Plus, as well, I think we also need to think about the final two terms, if not the last term of school. That if someone has paid school fees, really, from S1.
From S1, they've been in this school.
To S6.
And they have been in that same
school. Yeah, and you're going to use 2 hours to determine whether this person goes to the next level
or not,
or wastes another year to pay more money to be in your school. I think we need to revise and say, if someone has been in a school for quite some time, but they've now come to the second term of the last year in their school, they should not pay school fees. They should be under the school, and the school hands them over to UNEB, and all those costs are on the school, because someone has given you over 3 4 years.
There was a conversation that we're having with some friends of mine who are educationists, and you know, they were saying that it is something they need to petition to UNEB to make sure that, you know, it should actually pay these, it should be a sort of punishment for these schools. You know, they should
for
get their center
who,
numbers.
Who misses out on exactly exams, yet they were registered.
Exactly. For such an example in Iganga, you know, what you should do, you should take away the center number as a punishment. Do you think this could actually...
They should just close the schools.
They should close
because
the school.
Known that you can sit for your papers.
So taking away the center number is not enough?
It's not enough. They should just close the school. Because listen, I, as a headmaster of a school, can allow you to sit for a paper, even if you haven't paid school fees for 2 years.
as a headmaster.
What I will hold against you is your certificate, because that is important for you for the next
and you need it.
Yes.
Okay.
So it's very easy. There is no reason why the Basa should have chased these kids and also
talking about
them.
Summoning them.
So
with the, with
yeah,
the,
so the
fire.
School should be closed, the headmaster should be arrested, and the Basa should
and
be
and the Basa should also be put
we
in
have
prison.
A lawyer who's graduating.
Our team
have a room pay there, the headmaster.
Our
the
team headmaster. Was actually on ground as well, like I did mention earlier. And they talked to a couple of students as far as you know what their reactions would be regarding this particular instance. Let's listen to what the children had to say.
Let's be serious. The man is even heading the money where he has gone.
And the parents came, they pledged to pay later because they knew very well that they could not complete the amount as of this given period. But you wait for the day, then you send away people. The man was very hungry, seated just near that gate with a kind of
very sad, and of course a couple of tears right there.
It's also very dangerous. I know someone who has gone through a similar situation, but for them it was not for papers. It was a third term. This kid is supposed to, you know, sit for their final exams, but you know, the school decides to say if you haven't paid school fees, you're not going to come to attend school. And so the kid is home for almost 2 weeks. It is third term. He's not with the other kids revising. He's mentally traumatized. At the end of the day, the school, like Tina said, requires to pay full term. You understand? So of course, we know these are businesses, but you need to devise a business mechanism of how to run your business such that you do not squeeze your clients. Because at the end of the day, the client is key. If the client is not there, the school would be closed.
Thank you.
So I think these schools, they need to be taught a lesson. That Basa should be in prison. But also, to broaden the conversation, I think we need to sit down as, you know, young people and realize that education is not the only key. When you look at those kids crying on screen, it's like
their world has come to an end.
No, the world has not come to an end. Education is not the only key.
You keep getting by.
Yeah, actually, when you get education and get a degree, I don't know if you've seen
that
meme. That
door.
Opening the door and the
but
door.
They say get an education and you'll get a degree and doors will open.
But the
door
is still
banging at doors. Some people have failed to find the doors.
So I just like to just encourage those kids who have been, you know, refused from sitting exams, that it's not the end of the world.
Okay.
And there's a lot that they can do.
There's a lot you can do and, you know, make your life better.
No, in this next year, I think what we can do for them is make them understand that, yes, they missed this year's exams, but here's how they can redeem themselves and their parents so that they don't have to go through issues.
Okay.
Between the beginning, between now and up to next second term of next year, these kids could actually pick up jobs.
All right.
They can pick up jobs.
It is,
and they'll be able to just go pay for one term, uniform, ubazirina, buy in a center numbers, by registering. They go to their exams.
It is not the first instance that we're getting to hear out as far as you know, the UNEB examinations are concerned, all the way from PLE up to now USCE. And it's very unfortunate we still have such instances coming through. But we do hope that this could be one of the things that is addressed by the UNEB officials next year as they do get to release these results. And maybe it could be the last time it is happening. Urban Today gets in a very short break. But when we do get back, it will be the second hour of the show. And we get straight into our love letter. Interesting one that involves a witch.